Last one. One all.
Mixed results, and now we get a little look at the Malika Batra serve for the first time here. One all.
Straight away
there, and we can see that she started off with a serve with that smooth side to create that spin, changed that racket back round, and came in with the pimples. A tricky combination, and not an easy style to play against.
Yeah, so obviously she's been doing it for a long time, but it's a good spot. It's a good pick out.
Three, two, three.
Kiara goes long and drops both of her serves there. So an early advantage here for Malika Batra. Well, you've been studying both of these players. We know about Batra's little switch and flip there. Interesting to see how we categorize Miyu Kihara, the young Japanese player.
It's a tough one to call, because if you're too patient against Batra, then she has the capability of, you know, switching up with the attack. So I think Yoon really needs to just be selective on her choices, which ball she can be a bit more aggressive, but it's not always easy to read the spin on the ball when you're playing into those pimples.
5-2. Six.
Well, of the two players, it's Batra who's certainly settled much the better in this one.
Batra there looking for that forehand attack from the backhand corner. Just going a little bit too long off the end.
And again, the forehand not quite
six, four.
Going where it was intended to narrow the gap to 2 points, but she's still serving under the watchful gaze of Kirill Barabanov just behind her.
Nice play there from Kihara. Very selective. And just punching through that backhand. And that was the right ball to do it. The ball sat up a little bit higher, so she was able to penetrate it a little bit more.
That time, though, just a little bit all at sea, really, with that one. And again, we see it just float long. So she needs to compose herself. A little towel down there for Malika Batra, who did have a substantial lead, which has been eroded now.
Seven, six.
And this is a nice little run for the Japanese player, who just edges in front now.
A little bit less spin on that ball into her forehand. You couldn't quite read that.
Left. 7-0. Seven, eight.
Batra there deciding to use that backhand serve from the forehand corner.
That's a turnaround. Six of the last 8 points going to Miyu Kihara there. And it's also seen Malika Batra just lose a little bit of her focus.
9-7.
She needed that.
9-8.
Looked a little bit unsettled by the double bounce previously. Comes back within a point. But that one doesn't find the table, and as a result, it's 2 game points now for Miyukihara, who's fought back into this game very well indeed, and now is on the brink of winning it. And win it she does, 11-8.
Last one.
Ooh.
Gets a break, maybe a break one she needed there to level things up at the start of this second game, Manika Batra.
Hey, ha. 2-1.
Gave her the chance there, and she pounces on that one gleefully, Miyukihara.
Yeah, she can't afford to push that ball in the net. She needs to try and stay in the rally.
Just a little cramped up there on the backhand there, the Indian.
Four.
And she favors that shot, doesn't she, Manika Batra? The backhand from in front of the body, pushing out from her body.
Yeah, she's trying to mix it up a little bit. Sometimes she's actually attacking with the pimples. And I think that is a good idea, just to try and throw the Japanese off. But again, it's picking the right ball. I think that's what it's down to.
4-3.
Bit of support and encouragement from the coach there for Manika Batra.
There you go, you see the flip of the bat there, and she decided to punch with the smooth side of the rubber.
B6.
But Kihara's doing a great job at dealing with the pimples. She's quite happy to place the ball there.
It's an interesting one there. There was just a little couple of words that came from Kirill Barabanov there, who said, slow down.
Yeah, it's interesting because it might actually pay off if she just goes for patience and just grind her down a little bit more and try to force that error from the Japanese.
So points shared on those two serves following that timeout. And it's a 4-point game very quickly.
Oh! 4 line.
5 now, and Miyukihara has just quietly eased herself into a position of real dominance in this game as well, leading by 1 already. And that now gives her an opportunity to double that game advantage. 6 game points in the second.
That's better from Batra, sorry.
What'd she get right there?
Well, she took the ball nice and early with the pimples, and she just had a little bit more urgency in that attack.
But this time she pushes long.
1 bluff. Bluff.
She's on a roll, and Manika Batra needs to do something fast if she's to extend her stay here in Macau. That was 12 of the preceding 16 points won by the Japanese before she surrenders that one.
Oh, and that just clips the edge of the table.
Well, she'll take it. She needs anything she can get right now, Manika Batra. It's not much, but it's a slender lead. She needs to build now.
Let 2 feet.
Okay, I think the umpire there was telling the Japanese to make sure she keeps the ball above the table.
You can sense the frustration coming from the India camp here as she follows up. A couple of decent shots there with another one that just goes wide, Manika Batra. Oh, that's
B4.
Almost run along the net there.
Yeah, that was impossible to return that one. No chance. Okay, that was better from Batra. Just getting into the rally a little bit more, trying to force that error from her opponent. And I think that's probably the way she needs to go here if she's to stay in this match.
Five, four.
But anything she does is always an answer from the young Japanese player who's picked up the following point, and that's something that just drains a little more belief and confidence out of Batra every time it happens.
Five, all. Five, six.
It was a little bit timid, wasn't it? A little bit tame.
A little bit hesitant on that one.
Seven, five.
Oh, she's a study in focus and concentration and purpose, and as Batra towels off, her opponent can't wait to get on with this. She knows the end could be within sight. Oh, yeah.
8-5.
Did you hear that groan of frustration
from Batra? A bit of frustration there, yeah.
5-9.
Nearly there now.
2 points away. Wow, that was a quick change of direction there. Again, interestingly, using that backhand serve from the forehand corner to quickly move the Japanese out of position.
But again, she follows up an encouraging point with one surrendered, and that means that there are now 4 match points in the hands of Kihara here.
Yeah, she's struggling to get that forehand going a little bit. And when you're playing this class player, every point matters.
And there
Seven
it is.
Six.
And that is game comprehensive. 11-6 in the third. Kihara.